Hello and welcome to another episode of pianoTV. So since it's December, I've started thinking about like the year in review. And one idea I had that I thought would be kind of fun is to share the top 10 classical music pieces that I've enjoyed the most in 2017, this year. Now there's obviously going to be a very strong bias and leaning. Most of these are going to be like solo piano pieces and stuff like that just because I'm a piano player. But with that in mind, I thought, yeah, it would be fun to share my favorites, and I found audio clips for 6 out of 10 of them. And if you want to head over to the blog post that's associated with this, you'll find there are YouTube videos and links for all of the songs that I've mentioned in today's video. It would also be really awesome if you shared what your favorite piece is this year, what you're loving, in the comments below, and then maybe we can all have some new music to check out and get excited about. Anyway, let's get started. Ravel's Je Dos is a tune I fell in love with when I was creating the Impressionism in Music video. It was one of many pieces I put on a Spotify playlist for the video, and I found myself just like listening to it over and over again. This tune flows like water, and the title literally translates to something along the lines of water games. It has this harp-like, ethereal feel to it. It's a little magical, and it just sparkles with radiance. Martha Argerich has a really great version on YouTube, which I urge you to check out. It'll be linked over on the blog, or you could just, you know, do a YouTube search. I recently picked up Tchaikovsky's The Seasons, Opus 37B, and I've been playing through it. I've been listening to this whole bunch, and there's 12 pieces in this collection because it's one piece for every month. Now, the whole collection's awesome, and I've been listening to the whole thing, but what I'm going to share with you today is October, which is really like moody and a little dreary, very romantic, and I listened to this a lot when I was out for walks in the fall and stuff like that, so have a listen. Another piece that I've been listening to a ton this year is Asturias by Isaac Albéniz. This is from his Suite Española, and it's a little short individual piece, and I actually don't prefer the piano version of this, even though it was originally written on piano. I think the acoustic guitar renditions sound really, really cool, and I will share one on the video so you can have a listen to it, but it's got this really like nice, intense minor key sound with these random pops of volume that make the whole thing really exciting to listen to. I actually think this is one of the pieces that I featured on the video called Classical Music for People Who Don't Like Classical Music. So if that's kind of your jam, you might want to check out that video. But anyway, let's have a listen. Another collection that I've been really enjoying is Debussy's Preludes. And I haven't gotten into this on the piano yet, but I really want to. It's a pretty tough collection, but I've been listening to it a lot. And one piece that I want to single out in particular is called The Sunken Cathedral, which I believe I've also featured on this channel. I think it was in the video either on the music of Debussy or Impressionism in Music. Either way, it's really atmospheric and it tells this grand story of it's kind of like the story of Atlantis. I have a really strong preference for ambient piano music that is sort of relaxing to listen to, but isn't like boring to listen to. It's almost got like, this one in particular has almost like an ethereal magical vibe to it. So it makes it a little more interesting than just kind of like, I don't know, random ho-hum relaxing piano music. Let's have a listen. Thank you. And then we have the epic, very, very challenging, I've never attempted to play this, probably never will, Hungarian Rhapsody number 2 by Liszt. Now this is an oldie but a goodie. This is a piece that I've loved for a really long time. But I kind of rediscovered it this year when I did a video on this Hungarian Rhapsody. And I have a very specific memory of this year being on a road trip with Michael. I don't know why we were talking about Liszt, but we were on the subject of Liszt and I had to show him this piece because it's one of the most exciting, crazy Liszt pieces that I just happen to really love. So Valentina Lisica does an excellent version and I've linked her YouTube video of it over on the blog. But for now, let's take a listen to this recording. In September, I did a 30 days of listening to music, classical music challenge, and my favorite piece that I discovered from that channel was by Schumann, and it was his second piano sonata. I won't be able to show you this. I don't have a recording to share in this video, but again, you can go check out the blog post, find the video. It's since it's a sonata, it's a little longer than some of these other pieces that I've been sharing with you. But it's a really, really cool piece. It's got this minor key intensity. A lot of it's really fast paced. Pretty challenging. So sometimes like challenging piano music is really exciting and invigorating to listen to. It's pretty motivating. And this is one that I've been listening to quite a few times since September. So head on over to the blog to check it out. George Winston is a modern composer. So I can't show you a recording of his music because of copyright law, but he writes for solo piano and he writes everything from like jazzy music to more new agey style music. And since it's the Christmas season right now, I've been lately really enjoying his version specifically of Carol of the Bells, which is, you know, obviously one of the most awesome Christmas tunes. But he's got like a million different albums. Any of them are worth checking out. But the one that I've been listening to the most lately is his album December. Again, just because it's kind of, you know, tis the season. Chopin's Raindrop Prelude is another oldie but a goodie. It's a piece that I've known for a really long time, but have revisited it this year. And that was partly because this year we did a video series on Chopin's 24 Preludes. And it was also a piece that I adjudicated a music festival earlier this year. And this was a piece that someone played. So I kind of wanted to research it again and kind of get back into the zone with it. And it's such a cool piece. Like if you're going to listen to any Chopin, I think this is a really good example. It shows his style. It's really complete in and of itself, which is surprising because a lot of the preludes just feel like the preludes in general feel really incomplete, but this one feels like it kind of encompasses everything musically. It's got like really awesome, epic, big moments in the middle. It's got a nice shape to it. I feel like when I'm trying to describe music, I'm trying to describe like fine wine and I just don't have the words for it. And I just keep saying things like, it's really cool, check it out. But seriously, it's really cool, check it out. Shout out to Box Inventions in this video, and this is a collection of inventions, so it's not like one piece in particular, but I will show you the first invention in a moment here. I listen to these a ton because I've made a deal to myself to eventually work through all the inventions they're great brain exercises because you're basically playing like two simultaneous melodies together, and it's sort of like some of the easier late intermediate, early advanced Bach music. And I've been trying to get a little bit more into Baroque music because I tend to lean more in a romantic direction and I wanted to sharpen the saw a little bit. But anyway, That was the project I underwent, so I started listening to the inventions a whole bunch. So I figured they had a place on this video. Anyway, let's take a quick listen to his first invention in C major, so you can hear the two melodies that play against each other, one in the right hand, one in the left hand. If I want to listen to something really technically amazing, something that just like fires me up inside, it's Charles Alkin's 12th Etude specifically, but any of them are amazing. I'll link a really great YouTube recording of the video over on the blog and just listen to it for like at least a couple minutes, because it sort of starts innocuously, but then as the variations evolve, it gets more and more intense. I mean, Charles Alkin was a composer who I knew very little about prior to this year, and you guys encouraged me to start listening to his music, and it's been really fun diving into his just like crazy virtuosic music. And that is all for today's video. As I kind of mentioned earlier at the beginning of this video, you can definitely tell that I have like a piano-centric, more minor key preference for the types of music that I like listening to. So hopefully this list gave you, I don't know, maybe some new things to listen to. And again, like I said before, I'd love if you shared your own personal favorites in the comments, what you've been loving in 2017. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Subscribe if you haven't already, please. And if you want to check out the cards at the end, you can hang out with me over on social media and Patreon. Catch you later. I listened to a bunch of times this year is Isaac Albanez's, how do I even, Albanez's,